What it takes, life takes Visa. Visa Business gives you the financial tools to help reduce paperwork, increase efficiency, and maybe even save a tree or two. Your business is your life. Life takes Visa.
What are you going to get there?
The Ford Freestyle Crossover. More than 500 miles on a tank of gas.
Thanks for inviting me this weekend. All right, guys. I'll see you next week.
Bye, Dad.
Bye, Dad.
Bye.
Bold moves. They happen every day.
Adam, eyes here.
Fox Tuesday at 8. An autistic boy is dying.
He won't survive 3 days.
But the secret that will save him...
You have to tell me.
...is trapped in his mind.
What? Is his heart okay?
No.
It's the medical mystery with an ending so bizarre.
Hello, my buddies.
You can't miss it.
Liver cells under his arm. Wonder what he's got where his liver's supposed to be.
House, all new at 8, 7 Central, Fox Tuesday. Viewer discretion advised.
FedEx presents the Air and Ground NFL Players of Week 2. Eli Manning threw for 371 yards. Peyton Manning threw for 400. But with a 148 passer rating, the winning quarterback from Week 2 was Rex Grossman. Warrick Dunn rushed for 134 yards. Frank Gore ran for 127. But Rudy Johnson was last week's winning running back with 145 yards. Vote for the FedEx Air and Ground NFL Players of the Week at FedExFootball.com.
The Philadelphia Eagles looking to get last week out of their system. Tremendous first half, 338 yards of offense, and they lead the 49ers 24-3. San Francisco with all three timeouts. First and 10 from the 39. Empty backfield. Smith, short drop, and the slant is caught. And taken into Eagles territory by Maurice Hicks.
Yeah, and it was the Giants last week that went to a hurry-up offense that really changed the tempo of that game. Eli Manning started getting comfortable, getting the ball out of his hands faster, and that's something that the Eagles, I'm sure, worked on this week as the 49ers go to a no-huddle offense.
Frank Gore back in the game, first and 10. Gore inside the 45 to the 44.
Here's the thing about the 49ers, Kenny, is... they're young, and they don't expect to be in the playoffs this year, but they've got nothing to lose. They've got everything in the world to play for. They know they're not where the Eagles are, so they could just cut it loose here.
Smith on second down, complete to Gore, but he is met immediately by Sean Barber.
Sean Barber comes in on defense when the Eagles go to a 4-1-6. Look, they have six defensive backs. The one linebacker is Barber. At linebacker with them is Brian Dawkins, and they really like getting to that defense.
Brian coming up on the Visa Halftime Report from Seattle. Kurt Manafee, Terry Bradshaw, Howie Long, Jimmy Johnson will bring you scores and highlights and the Fox Sports ticker. It's all coming up during our Visa Halftime Report. And that's Jim Johnson. We have our Jimmy Johnson.
Yep.
Jim, the tremendous defensive coordinator with the Eagles.
He doesn't like to be called Jimmy Johnson.
Third down and one. Gore. And a good job by Jim Johnson's crew. It will depend on the spot.
He looks a little short here. Okay? It looks like he's about a foot short. Maybe a little bit more. Not a great spot. Like Frank Gore gave a lot better effort than that.
So the 49ers facing... fourth down and one.
like the 49ers are going to run this down, and then they look just indecisive, and then just punt it.
Why? Why not go for it?
Yeah, you know, I mean, not just because the Eagles offensively can't be stopped, and they don't want to fall. They don't want to give the Eagles a chance for great field position with a couple of timeouts left in 40 seconds. Not to Donovan McNabb, a guy they haven't been able to stop or slow down all day.
At best, though, the Eagles would have time for only two plays, maybe only one, if the 49ers went for it and were stopped here.
Well, I think it's a statement more about what Mike Nolan thinks about his defense right now than anything else. Andy Reid sending out a big, loud memo. Watch the fake. I agree with the 49er fans, though, Kenny. I think you should go for it here. I think the way...